General Lucas. So this operation was not the nature of operation, purely checkpoint operation na nagkabulagaan, random operation or intelligence-driven operation or what?
Sir, before I will answer your question, please allow me to read my opening statement. To the esteemed members of the Honorable Body, the Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs, chaired by Honorable Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa, the Secretary of the Department of the Interior and Local Government, Secretary Benjamin Abalos Jr., sir, maraming salamat po sa suporta. Director General Moro Bergilio Lasso of PDEA for the technical support, sir, maraming salamat din po. Fellow officers from the Philippine National Police, pleasant morning to all of us. On behalf of PRO Calabarzon, we wish to extend our appreciation in this invitation, an opportunity for us to inform the public of what transpired on April 15, 2024 that eventually led to the seizure of more than 1 ton of meth, commonly known as shabu. In response to the marching order of the Chief of the Philippine National Police that the PNP should be visible on the streets, the PRO identified strategic areas where to set up checkpoints operation to assist in the public and preempt lawless elements from the riparios activities. It is during the conduct of checkpoint operation last April 15, 2024 at around 7:20 a.m. by the members of Alitagtag Municipal Police Station along Barangay Pinagkurusan, Alitagtag, Batangas, the team, led by Police Captain Luis De Luna Jr., was able to flag down a silver Photon passenger van with plate number CBM5060, with several plate numbers found in front of the passenger seat and loaded with sacks containing clear plastic containers with white crystalline substance. Examination conducted by PDEA confirmed the same to be shabu. At exactly 9:15 in the morning, I informed the Chief PNP, Police General Romel Francisco Marbil, of the discovery of the illegal drugs. Ang instruction po niya is to secure the suspected illegal drugs. For 43 hours, I acted as the Crown Commander from the time of unloading until the official turnover to PDEA in Quezon City. The driver of the flagdown van was later identified as Mr. Ajalon Michael Sarate, who claimed to have no knowledge of the illegal drugs confiscated in this operation, was arrested and subjected to on-site inquest proceedings on April 15, 2024 for violation of Section 5 of Republic Act 9165 and Section 31 of Republic Act 4136. As several plate numbers were initially found inside the van. The confiscated illegal drugs were continuously inventoried in accordance with existing laws for almost 35 hours. Likewise, backtracking of the CCTV footages were undertaken, which led us to Nasugbo, Batangas, where the illegal drugs were offloaded from a sailboat. Operatives were also able to identify the true identity of the arrested suspect and his cohorts who were in three separate vehicles found to be in convoy with the intercepted Photon van. Lateral coordination with the other law enforcement agencies were made for further verification of the suspect and other identified personalities. At this juncture, I would like to take the opportunity to publicly acknowledge the assistance and support extended to us by Honorable Edelberto Pungos, the Mayor of the Municipality of Alitagtag, Batangas, Honorable Alfredo Mertola, the Barangay Chairman of Pinagkurusan, Alitagtag, Batangas, and all the members of their council. The traffic enforcers who directed the flow of traffic under the heat of the sun, members of the Batangas Prosecutor's Office and media practitioner, our witnesses during the almost 35 hours of continuous inventory. Wala pong tulugan ito, Your Honor. And most of all, the people of Barangay Pinagkurusan, Alitagtag, Batangas, who stayed with us for almost 43 hours. During that time,
excuse me. What do you think, bakit umabot ng 43 hours?
Sir, because of the volume po, sir.
Volume?
Opo.
Napakarami?
Yes, sir.
Tapos yung weighing scale ninyo, isa-isang dadaan doon?
Yes, sir. Because nung tinanong namin, sir, yung prosecutor kung pwedeng by 10 na lang, sir. Hindi okay. Po sa pumayag because yung confiscated drugs po, sir, nakalagay individually sa plastic container.
So one by one? Bawat plastic lagay sa weighing scale?
Yes, Your Honor.
Plastic lagay ganun?
Yes, Your
Hindi
Honor.
Pwede yung isang buong sako nilagay nyo doon?
Hindi po, Your Honor.
Okay. Thank you. Kaya umabot ng 43 hours?
Yes, sir.
Continue.
During that time, the PNP experienced the hospitality of the people of Pinagkurusan, Alitagtag, Batangas. Sa inyong lahat, maraming salamat po. Your Honor, if during our presentation, you will notice some lapses in our courses of action, please guide us, help us, because on that day, everybody was overwhelmed because of the large amount of illegal drugs confiscated. Dahil kung hindi, sino pa ang magtuturo sa amin? Sino pa ang magtatanggol sa amin? In my previous appearances in this honorable body, lagi ko po kayong naririnig na less than 1% lang of the 230 strong PNP personnel ang naliligaw ng landas. Your Honor, these police officers who are part of this accomplishment are part of the 99% police officers whose only mission is to serve and protect the community. It is with high hope that at the end, that the conclusion of this hearing, the PNP be recognized for this accomplishment. Maraming salamat po, and once again, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat.
Thank you for that information. For the record, I want to wholeheartedly congratulate you for that accomplishment. Wala akong duda.
Yes,
I just want to set the record straight.
Yes, sir.
Wala akong duda sa inyo. Baka sabihin ninyo, pinatawag ko kayo dito ng hearing dahil marami akong pagdududa. Gusto ko lang liwanag ninyo, paliwanag ninyo sa buong kapuluan kung ano yung nangyari talaga.
Yes.
Ang kung habang nagsalita ka, masyadong mabigat yung delivery of words mo. Mukhang galit ka na siguro sa akin, ha?
Hindi po, sir. Senator,
congratulations.
Gusto lang muna namin din magpasalamat sa inyo sa pagpapatawag nyo para mailahad sa ating mga kababayan ang nangyari. At of course, para pasalamatan ng gusto ang police at ang mga tiga Batangas, lahat po ng tumulong, ang mga Coast Guard natin, lahat po, mga piskal, lahat po ng tumulong. Salamat po.
And thank you rin, sir. Being isang former Chief PNP, thank you for promoting spot promotion doon sa Chief of Police ng Alitagtag na nagakandak ng checkpoint. Thank you. At least recognize yung kanilang effort. Thank you. Going back to my question, kindly answer the question. Was that intelligence driven or random checkpoint, bulaga lang sa checkpoint or what?
Random checkpoint, Your Honor.
Random. Okay. Kasi yung ibang nag-isip na sinit up lang daw, pero ganun. So, klaro, random checkpoint. Checkpoint. Okay. So, that's talagang Lord, the Lord is watching us. Sabi ni Lord, dapat mahuli ka. Dapat ma-checkpoint ka. Di ba? Dapat ma-checkpoint ka. Dahil kung hindi yun na-check, napakaraming buhay masisira sa Shabu na yun. So magpapasalamat tayo sa sipag ng inyong mga taohan dyan. Yun nga lang. Diritso na ako sa next tanong ko kanina. Why do, first time natin ito ngayon na na-experience na Shabu, ang traffickers ay mga puti. Di ba? Parang ano tingin mo?
Mr.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Senator, pasensya na po kayo. Ba?
Yeah.
Pero ito po kasi ay sub judice po. Nasa korte na po ngayon. At kami po'y nag-iingat lang at gusto po namin talagang makulong lahat ito.
I'm not yeah. asking the identity sa mga tao dito. I am just a general impression. Bakit nag-ship yung operations from mga Chinese ngayon, mga puti na involved? Yun lang, that's a general I don't think this will jeopardize the case in court. Ang akin lang is, if you want to answer, bakit kaya biglang nag-ship na ganito, ibang tao na involved?
Your Honor, in as much as I want to answer your question, however, yung case na po is nasa court and there is an ongoing case build-up with the Department of Justice dito po sa pangyayaring ito, Your Honor. Sorry po.
Okay, but I just want to impress upon you that yung sub judice na yan, there is a Supreme Court ruling na whatever gustong malaman ng isang legislative inquiry ay hindi po yan covered ng sub judice rule, sabi ng Supreme Court. But anyway, that's beyond the sabihin ko lang sa inyo, sinabi ko lang yan.
Mr. Chairperson.
Yes,
lahat po ibibigay po namin sa inyo,
okay,
lahat po
ng kaya nga sir, kaya nga yung executive session natin,
sir. Yes, sir.
I'm willing to hear everything.
Yes, sir. Lahat okay. po ng info gusto nyo, bibigay po namin sa inyo,
okay,
po
sir.
Lahat.
Sir,
yes, sir.
Thank you for that. Meron pang gusto magsalita about this?
Sir, at this point lang po, anyway, nandirito na rin po lahat. I would just like to emphasize na archipelagic tayo, marami tayong isla. At kung makikita po natin ay puro tubig po ito, tamang-tama po andito po ang ating Coast Guard na tingin ko kailangan talaga ng suporta po talaga sila. At hindi lang suporta sa gamit, sa sinasabi nilang radar, pero higit sa lahat sa polisiya, yung tinatawag na pleasure boats, no, dahil hindi raw nila maipasok, no, ng marina. At this point, Mr. Chairperson, can I give the floor to Commodore Tobilla of the Coast Guard?
Yes, Commodore Tobilla, you have the floor.
Of course, the complexities of our country is really, when it comes to maritime, is very vast, no, ika nga nila, sir, no. And there's a dire need for us to strengthen our policies and capacitate the Coast Guard in improving our technical capacity in monitoring such boats or watercrafts within our coastal areas and our sea lanes, sir.
Thank you. So, what, anong mga gusto mong pulisiya na pwede natin i-amend? May mga batas ba kayong pwede i-amend para to capacitate you some more?
Yes, sir. I do believe, sir, that the Marina has amendments for the Memo Circular 2019-01 or the Regulations of Pleasure Yachts in our country. And as the enforcing body of Marina Regulations, we are hoping that this amendment will soon come into reality so that we could strengthen our inspections on this pleasure yacht, sir.
Okay. You please coordinate with Marina. And kung kailangan ng Marina ng legislation para dyan, coordinate with us para gawan natin.
Yes, Your Honor.
Kasi yung sabi mong i-amend ng Marina is, was that executive order? Or
it is a memo circular.
A memo circular. So purely administrative in nature. So if you want it to be a legislated law, then coordinate kayo sa Marina and my COMSEC is ready to accommodate everything that you want done as far as legislation is concerned.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you very much.